We'll be right back. Merci beaucoup à Max Cooper, encore plus de bruit pour lui. On va interviewer Max Cooper juste là pour les personnes qui veulent entendre l'interview et lui poser des questions. Venez avec nous là. Et les personnes qui veulent encore du son, le son reprend avec Employee of the Year. Alors je vous demande un maximum de bruit pour eux. So we'll do this interview in English. So if you guys have questions here, you can I will give you the mic. And people online, I'm sure you have a lot of questions for Max Cooper. So now is the time you can ask your question on the Facebook Live, and we will select the best one and ask them to Max. Okay. Nice. Right? Nice. I have a lot of questions for you.
Sure.
First of all, how did it go tonight? Did you enjoy playing this beautiful museum?
Yeah, of course. I really enjoyed most of the time when I play. I can only see the visuals on my screen, you know, because the screen's usually behind me, so it was really nice sort of looking out to the side and just seeing the museum and the statues and then just the just working with the space. So thank you for, we had a bit of a setup today, didn't we? So thank you for working with me and making it immersive, you know. It was really nice, thank you.
Yeah, it was some work to install everything, and because of these beautiful videos. Who makes these videos? You make it? Or all the visuals you make them?
I worked with, every video is a different chapter of a story, which is working with a different artist. So I've sort of devised the storyline and the concept for each part, and then find people to work with for each one. So it's there's many people involved. There's a website called emergence.maxcooper.net, which has all the videos and all the ideas explained and clips and stills and because the whole thing's a story.
I'm just checking if there is some question online, but sure. I have another question. When you produce a song, do you see the visuals and do you produce it with the visuals? Or
this project was it was more or less like a score, right? It was like writing a music for a film or something. So it started off with the concept, the storyline and what each chapter should be. And then I would write each piece of music to fit each part of the story, you know. So it's called Emergence, and it starts off with natural laws, and then it goes into the Big Bang and planet formation and stuff, and then early life, and then humans arrive. And when humans arrive, it all gets more dark and intense. So the music goes more techno and more aggressive, you know. So the music was made to fit the different sections of the story, basically.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Do you guys hear us or no? No, you can't hear us. Yeah, it's kind of difficult because there is a lot of music. I hope in the live stream it works well. I hope.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
They probably can't hear us either.
Maybe you have some questions. Yes.
Okay. Hey, Max. I'm a very huge fan of you, and my question as an architect is, I know that you work a lot with space. Just your song is according to the space, and I've seen you've been working on this project of 4D sound.
Yeah.
Will you make it in France someday?
I hope so. The next one is in Berlin in, what's the date of it? 14th of December in Berlin. The next one, yeah. I'd love to bring it to France as well, but if I can, I will. But yeah, I will. Thank you. But yeah, come to Berlin, 14th of December. Yeah, 14th of December in Berlin. You should do it.
Any other questions here? No? Okay. I'm just checking if online, if there is question. Give me just 1 second. Okay. Okay, sorry guys, I'm just...
Yeah, you're setting yourself quite a task to... Yeah. To do the whole show and then straight away interview and get the questions.
Yeah, exactly.
So it's pretty intense.
It's pretty complicated. So a question from Melissa. It's really a challenge to perform during this tour. It's not too difficult to follow your videos. Mm. So maybe her question, I'm not sure to understand, but maybe...
I think it's about the performance. So yeah, I'm controlling the videos as well as the music.
Exactly.
The challenge is to do that at the same time.
Yeah.
The way I just spent a long time setting up a system so that it sends MIDI into Ableton, and then Ableton sends OSC messages to Resolume. And I set it up so that every tweak I make to the audio, you know, when I bring in a sound or launch a clip or change a filter or do some glitch effects or live drumming, everything I do in the audio also controls the video. So in a sense, I can just jam with the audio and the video follows. There are some video-specific controls, but most of the controls do both at the same time. So that's the way I've designed to be able to do the visuals and the music. And I just much prefer doing that. It's like, you know, there's so much potential for doing both at the same time, and it's just a lot of fun. It just opens doors creatively for me to be able to do that. So I'll continue developing that. But the next album project will be another. You know, I'll keep developing the video thing, and a lot of the projects I'm doing now are like surround visual as well. So like tonight we had, you know, the visuals on several surfaces, but I've been experimenting with doing more and more surfaces, and then the next step will be to combine that with the surround sound project so that this, you know, you can be immersed in different sound sources as well as different video sources. So then it can become more and more, you know, I want to wrap the audience up inside this like bubble, you know?
Yeah, I see. Okay, I'm just checking if there is another question. Do you make your live before with hardware setup? I guess so.
Yes. I use a lot of hardware.
What hardware do you use?
For the last album, I use a lot of Moog Sub 37 and actually Prophet. I've got two. I've got a Prophet 6 and a Prophet 8. And I love the, you know, the Dave Smith Prophets. I just love beautiful synths. And then I use a lot of pedals and tape delays. I've got loads of pedals. I love distortion pedals and sort of lots of pedals that degrade the sound, and a lot of the glitchy sounds I make, I work with, you know, lots of chains of pedals doing extreme effects, which I can, you know, render out and then pick bits out of for these like clicks and glitchy sounds. So yeah, no, I'm really into my analog stuff. Although that's only the last album, really. I started off digital because, you know, analog stuff expensive. So I didn't have money to buy analog synths when I started. So it's just in the last three years or so, I've been collecting. My studio's growing and growing. But yeah, I've got the disease, you know, the analog disease, and just wanted to get more and more all the time.
So you studied genetics, right?
Yeah.
And you are a doctor, right?
Yeah.
When and why did you want to do music for a living?
Music's a lot of fun.
I mean, genetics are not
fun. It was fun as well. It was more just music was a hobby, and then I was suddenly earning more money from that than I was from science. So I thought, oh, why not try this full time for a while? And then that was like 10 years ago or something. So yeah, I just got down the slippery slope, you know.
Okay. Can you give us again your website about visual?
Sure. Emergence.maxcooper.net.
Okay.
We're going to release. So that's got all the visuals you saw on there, like a separate and all explained as well. But we're also going to release like a Blu-ray. I'm doing a project with Dolby. Like Dolby have an Atmos system. It's like a cinema surround sound system. And I've actually done this whole album project in Dolby Atmos in this surround sound system. So we'll release like a Blu-ray and a DVD. And if you have like a 5.1 or a surround sound system, people can play all the visuals and surround sound at home.
Oh, that's great.
So that's coming in a few months, basically.
Great.
Yeah.
So follow Max Cooper on his Facebook. He will announce everything on his Facebook page, I guess. And I have one last question. You played, I think, 6 times in a row this week, your live. What's your favorite moment you had so far? Not in these 6 days, but in general.
I think, to be honest, my favorite moment has been doing the surround, like experimenting with the visual setup. That's what I'm really enjoying at the moment. I actually bought extra projectors. So a lot of gigs now I'm turning up to bring more projectors, and we're putting a load of projectors in. And it was the same at the Get Lyric gig, you know, where we had the multiple walls.
Yeah.
So that's a relatively new thing, experimenting with different surfaces. So that's been the most fun thing, actually, the last week pushing that forward.
Cool. Well, thank you very much.
Thank you for having me.
And
pleasure.
And we have a little gift for you. It's the mystery box. It's the museum that offers you a gift.
Really,
tonight.
Some sort of priceless artifact. Oh, nice.
Yeah, it's a little.
It's a statue.
It's a statue.
A big statue. Amazing. Thank you to the museum. It's like all of their work.
Yeah, exactly.
Amazing.
It's all the work.
So coffee table book.
Sorry?
I said coffee table book.
Yeah. So, awesome. And thank you to the museum because
they hosted it tonight. Thank you for,
and
I hope we didn't ruin their.
Thank you. Thank you guys, you were awesome.
Thank you to you guys. Ooh.
And thank you to everyone online. You were you're a lot. I didn't look at the figures, but I see that you are more than 100,000. So thanks so much to follow us each week.
We should say thank you to everyone who went online to have a watch and listen.
You can watch it. Okay, thank you and see you next Monday and next Monday and next Monday and next Monday. See you and have a good week.